Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la
رواه البخاري ومسلم. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the clock is ticking. As we see in these Western countries, when once a year there is a big, huge sale, people line up outside the store for 2 days or 3 days, depending what they are looking and how much reduction in the price has gone. Ramadan is a divine sale. Sale from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where anything nafila, which is extra, will get the reward of fariza, which is obligatory act, and any fariza will be multiplied 70 times. See? So, do not let this opportunity pass by you. And there is one very major reason for that. That many of our brothers and sisters who were with us last year, they are not with us. So we don't know. We only know our date of birth. We don't know the date of death. And that is such a great mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the essence of Iman, a Muslim is always standing by or on call. And to be on call, we have to follow Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in every single aspect of our life. The purpose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given for this particular month and for fasting is taqwa, that is God consciousness. The more we increase in God consciousness, the better individual we become. And it enables us to fulfill our duties and responsibilities, which are twofold. One towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the other one towards the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anybody who is less fortunate than you are, you have a duty and responsibility to participate in whatever way you can, not only by paying zakah and other duties and responsibilities, but also deeply involving with the community projects. That is the sign of taqwa. Now let us go into some, you know, important details about the fasting. In Islam, we have two kinds of fasting. One is fariḍa, that is obligatory. And the only obligatory fasting is during the holy month of fasting, Ramadan. See? And two more fastings come as near as the fariḍa, according to the jurist. What are those? The second one is Sawm al-Kaffarat, meaning if you missed Ramadan fasting for one reason or the other, to make up the number is fariḍa, it is also obligated. And if you have committed a mistake, like you were fasting, but your mind started thinking about the food. For example, you say to yourself, oh, I am craving for the Chinese food. So what the heck, let me break my fast. You break your fast for no reason. Then you have to give the kaffara. That will be the 60 days of fasting as a fine for you for no reason. reason you have disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the third one is Nazr, where you pledge to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will fast for this many days, or I will perform the prayer for a reason or a condition, or volunteering yourself that alhamdulillah, so many bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I want to show my gratitude, I pledge to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I will fast for so many days. So whenever you pledge a nazr, it becomes on you obligatory and you have to do it. The second kind is a sawm al-masnoon. They all come under tatawwu. Tatawwu is everything that is other than obligate. So the sunnah fasting is 9th and 10th of Muharram. As you know, Muharram is the first month in the Islamic calendar year. And the 9th day of 12th month, Dhul Hijjah, Yom Arafah or Arafah, when Wukuf Arafah takes place. You know, when people are going to Hajj, that day is recommended by Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and Ayyam Bil, white days. White days means when the moon is full, 13, 14 and 15 of every month is the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recommending. Then you have optional extra, what we call nafila. Under that come the 6 days of the 10th month, immediately after Ramadan. First Shawwal, it is haram to fast because it is Eid al-Fitr. But the remaining 29 or 28 days of Shawwal, you are required to fast in line, in order, or scattered. 6 days. So 30 days of Ramadan, multiply 10 times 300 days. 6 days multiply 10 times 60 days, that will cover the entire year and you will get the reward of it. Islamic calendar year is only 354 days. We don't have 31 days or 28 or 28 or 31 days in Islamic calendar. So, 6 days of Shawwal. To complete the whole year reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every Monday and Thursday. The reason for that, these angels who are recording our words and our deeds, their duty changes. They take our a'mal and deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that was the reason why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam fasted on Mondays and Thursdays. And that is also the reason that you can never, you're not allowed to be angry with anybody for more than 3 days. Because before your deeds are taken to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no matter what reason you are angry with somebody, you have to make your peace so you can gain or attain the good pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 15th day of the 8th month, Sha'ban. We are in the 8th month now. Then 8 days of the 12th month. You know, 9th day is the wukuf Arafat. But if you can fast from 1st Zilhijjah to 8th, that will be extra recommended by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then we have haram days of fasting. 5 days it is unlawful to fast. 2 days are Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. That is the 12th month, 10th is Eid al-Adha. Then you connect to it Ayyam التشريح. When we say after every prayer, you know, takbir, to remind the sacrifice of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam for his son. So in the 12th month you have 4 days, 10, 11, 12 and 13. These 4 days, no matter what, you can't even make up what you missed from Ramadan. It is unlawful to fast. And Eid al-Fitr is the 5th day, first day of Shawwal. It is haram to fast. Now there are obligatory acts. Number one, Muslims are required to do taharri, meaning find out, investigate, go to the higher places to look for the Hilal Ramadan, the crescent moon of the holy month of Ramadan. It is a very highly emphasized sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it is also mentioned in the Holy Quran in verse number 184 of Surah Al-Baqarah. فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمُ الشَّهْرَ. Whoever witness, here witness means you witness first the Hilal of Ramadan and then it is proven that the Ramadan is started. So that is number one. Number two, no fasting is valid without the intention. Part of the God consciousness. God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want you to do whatever you are doing with consciousness. So if you did not have the niyyah, the intention, the fasting is not valid. It will only be counted as nafila or extra optional act. And the niyyah has to be one day before. That is why you say wabi sawmi ghadin nawaitu. You know, for tomorrow I'll be fasting. So you have to say the niyyah one day. As soon as you see the moon, you make your niyyah. You can do it for the whole month of Ramadan. That's fine. Then you don't have to do every single day. It is the function of your mind, and it creates the consciousness in the believers. So niyyah is important. Even the zakah is not valid. If before giving the money, if you don't make the niyyah, the intention that this is from the zakah fund I'm giving, otherwise it will be counted as a general fund, will not be counted as a zakah. Number three, nothing has to enter your body, even a drop of water, you know, nothing has to go, because it is total abstaining from the food and drink in one way, and the lawful marital relationship on the other way. These are the two things which are to be controlled, because these two things, people when they enter into the excesses, they go wrong in their life. So, third, nothing goes to the body. The fourth one, no law, even lawful marital relationship between dawn and dusk. Nights are permissible for you. Number five, even the things which make you desire, you know, the intimacy with your wife or with your husband, even those are not allowed as a fair. Number six is you intentionally vomit by putting your fingers and hands into your mouth and you're trying to vomit. That is not, is not allowed. At-taqayyub bil-irada, to vomit intentionally, that is not allowed. Of course, full mouth vomiting, it happens on its own, of course your fast has been broken or invalid. Now, what are the sunnah of the fasting? As-suhoor bit-ta'khir wa fil waqt. Meaning, don't take suhoor at 1 o'clock at night or before you sleep at 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock or after Tarawih. No, wait. You know, wait till dawn before the Fajr prayer as much as you can delay within the time, not without the time, within the time. That is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Number two, at-ta'jeel bil iftar. You know, iftar time has come, but you are not breaking your fast. You say, oh, I'll do it after Maghrib prayer. No, don't do that. You know, at-ta'jeel. These will bring the barakah and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Third, al-jood was-sakha wal-infaq. This is the time you have to show that the love of Allah in your heart is greater than the material wealth. So you will be tested how generous you are, how many projects you are participating, how many times you are thinking about the poor people and poor families, students, all the masajid, host the iftar for the Muslims. وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. Are you competing in that? Are you going in to be in the front line to participate in that? That is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In a hadith, it is reported that during the holy month of Ramadan, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so generous. The metaphor uses like a strong wind. When a strong wind comes, it touches every one of us. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was touching all the needy and deserving people with his generosity and spending on them. So this is the time, as I say, divine sale. Don't miss this sale. Go. Because whatever you will be paying, وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ Surah Fatir, فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُ. Allah will replace it. And the replacement will be 700 times multiplied. Number four, feed the people. Number five, make a connection with the Holy Quran. We can't have any connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without the Holy Quran. Those are the glorious words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the connection with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ عَطَاءَ اللَّهِ. Whoever obeys Prophet has obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Quran, we have to understand the way Prophet has translated into his words and into his actions. And the sixth one is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam of retreat. Last 10 days, make sure if you have certain holidays in your account, take those 10 days so you can connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can focus in past 11 months mistake and make a program in coming 11 months that you will be the one who will be precisely imitating the footsteps of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm going to finish early today because there are certain projects of this masjid and you are always early to leave the masjid, so we can use those few extra minutes to inform you that how can you participate participate in this divine sale, and how can you grab the blessings, mercies, bounties and favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant his speedy recovery to all the sick people and his maghfirah to all those who have passed away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide each and every one of us to give extraordinary importance to the holy month of fasting Ramadan, and to guide us to fill every moment of this special time with a good deed and with a good word. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر, وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد الخلائق والبشر. قال الله تبارك وتعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعدد من صلى وصام, وصل على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعدد من قعد وقام, وصل على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين والصحابة أجمعين والتابعين وتبع التابعين وسلف الصالحين وأولياء الكاملين وعلماء الراسخين إلى يوم الدين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين, اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه, اللهم وحد كلمة المسلمين, اللهم ألف بين قلوب المؤمنين, اللهم اغفر لجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات, إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات, برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله رحمكم الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون, واذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم, ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وأجل وأهم وأتم وأعظم وأكبر, والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن محمد رسول الله, حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح, قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة, الله أكبر الله أكبر, لا إله إلا الله.